How's it and welcome to a review of the Ford Figo Freestyle. It's built on the normal Ford Figo, but has slightly more ground clearance and a couple of different engine options. It's actually a really nice looking car. I'm not wild about this brown color, but as you can see, there are dark gray wheels on it, quite a lot of sort of ruggedy off-road looking bits, and even some decals on the bottom of the doors. The front end of the Freestyle is largely unchanged from the normal Figo. It's obviously got sort of all the cross bits here and there, like the extra skid plates at the bottom. There are a couple of interesting quirks to this car though. There's no way to open the boot from the outside unless you disassemble the key and put it in there, or you press the fob twice and then it pops the boot open. Once you open the boot, there's the usual sort of parcel shop vibe going on here. But one of the things quite unique to this Freestyle is the amount of sort of ruggedized rubber matting going on here. So there's like this rubber mat in the back here, which actually is quite useful. If you caught kids around and live near the beach, having a rubber mat in the back, wet towels, sandy slops, that's really clever. That rubber mat vibe goes on inside the car too. So when you want to unlock the car, usually you would press the unlock button once, it will unlock the driver's door. And then the second time you press it, it will unlock the rest of the car. Not so much in the Freestyle. You press it once and the lights go on. It's kind of like an identifier. You have to press it twice to unlock the driver's door and three times to unlock the rest of the car. When you lock the Freestyle, you can press the lock button once and it locks the car. If you press it twice, it beeps at you. If it beeps twice like that, it means one of the doors is not closed properly. Probably the boot that I left open. If all your doors are properly closed and you press the lock button twice, it beeps at you once. And then you know your car's locked, which is quite useful in a society that's full of like key jamming and stuff. There's no keyless entry, so you have to press the button to unlock the car. But what it does have inside the car is it does have a start button, so you can get in the car, chuck the key over there, press the button and fire up the car. Right, let me talk you through the interior quickly. So the door has this color matching inset over here. It's got full electric windows. One thing that I do find really interesting about the Figo is that it's got this little compartment over here. It doesn't kind of match anything over here, so it's not like an airflow thing. It seems like quite a cool place to stash your drugs or your weed. The door has a couple of bottle holders in it and closes quite nicely. Down on the right here, you have your lights. You can pop the boot over here, sort of general settings. The steering wheel only has this one little control section, which is quite useful in that when you're listening to audio, those two buttons are skipping forward and backwards. When the phone rings, it's answer and hang up, which is really clever. And then up and down is your volume. As I said, that's the start button. Interesting place for it. It's kind of interesting to, like, you have to reach around the steering wheel to kind of get there, but it's cool. The dash is quite symmetrical, actually looks quite cool. You have the rev count on the left, and then on the right you have this fuel gauge, which is like the same size as the rev counter. In the center you have your speedometer, and then you have your trip computer in the bottom screen. The temperature and the car temperature and the outside temperature stay at the bottom, and then as you go through the trip computer, it shows you all the various sort of trip computer options. So far, fuel economy in this has been 7 liters per 100, quite a lot of open road driving. In the center console, you have a screen over there which does support Android Auto. You've got all your sort of usual controls over here, volume, tuning, skipping, etc. It does have climate control here, but it's not dual climate control. So you only have one temperature setting, but otherwise all the usual climate control features. There's this cool little shelf over here, which doesn't quite work with my phone. I do have a Note 20, so it's like a really big phone, but anything smaller would actually fit in there quite nicely. That's clever. That's one of the things that's sort of missing from most cars today, somewhere constructive to put your phone. Down at the bottom here, you have the two USB-A ports. Those little sort of white things around the ports are actually illuminated, so at night you can kind of see them nicely. And then there's a cigarette lighter vibe going on here. You don't see a lot of those in the cars anymore. It comes with a 5-speed manual gearbox, and in the center console over here you actually have like a whole bunch of sort of storage compartments around the gear lever. As the car journalists like to say, it's a very well appointed car. In other words, it's got all the cool stuff in it. It's got airbags in it. This is powered by a 1.5 liter engine. So here's the thing with the Freestyle. The regular Figo has a 1 liter turbocharged engine producing like 88 kilowatts. This has a 1.5 liter naturally aspirated engine producing 91 kilowatts. So like there's 3 kilowatts in it, it makes very little difference. I really, really, really like this engine. It's still a three-pot, so it's kind of got that three-pot raspy sound to it. But the linear power delivery on this car is actually really pleasant. For a 91 kilowatt engine, this thing absolutely goes fantastically. On the interior, you've kind of got these cloth seats, which are quite comfortable. I've done about 600-700 kilometers in this car. I've found it to be great, comfortable. The clutch is light. The gearbox and the clutch work together perfectly. The engine's fantastic. The torque sits at about 150 newton meters. So more than sufficient for a car this size. It's just really pleasant to drive. The sound is okay. It's not like anything fancy, but it's good enough for this car. With the Android Auto system and the super responsive touchscreen, it does everything you need it to do. It goes really well. It handles quite acceptably. I think on Clarence Drive here at the moment, a couple of corners I pushed it into that were a little bit sketchy, but on the whole, like, actually not too bad for the car that it is. And then it's got like a couple of quirky little bits in it. It's obviously showed you the boot to like open and close. That is like a little bit quirky. But if you have a look here, they put the mirror adjuster thingy up in the door here, which is, I've never seen it over there. But it kind of makes a lot of sense and works quite well. Obviously, the opposite side is like completely blank and that looks a bit strange. As I mentioned earlier, the rubber mat vibe is going on the inside there. You'll see at the back here too, there's rubber mats everywhere. So all in all, it's like, it's actually quite a cool little car. Pricing starts at about 260,000 Rand for this one. This is the Ford Figo Freestyle Titanium, which is actually not bad, all things considering. So This is a great little car. It drives well, it looks good, it's well equipped, and the price point actually is really, really good. Thanks for watching my review on the Ford Figo Freestyle Titanium. If you like this video, please hit the subscribe button at the bottom. I'd really dig that.